Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this tutorial I'll be showing you how to use the new Content Aware Fill in Photoshop 2019, and very quickly and easily go from something like this to that. There we go. Now if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and of course share. Just click on share. You can subscribe if you haven't already done so. You also can support my channel through Patreon. There's a link for that in the description. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop. There's a link for that right down there. Okay, let's get to it. The new Content Aware Fill here inside of Photoshop 2019 is amazing. It's very easy to use, very fast, does a great job. You can see it right here. Here's the original picture, and then here's the cleaned up version. Now the hardest part about this whole bit here are these clouds in the background. Very hard to get these clouds exactly right. You can do the whole thing down here very easily. It'll take a little while, but you can do all this stuff with the clone stamp tool, no big deal. But getting the clouds right, very, very tricky on a picture like this. And this does a perfect job. Okay, let me show you how this is done. I'm just going to delete this layer up here. Just come down, hit the trash can, and delete that. Okay, there's the original picture. Real easy to use the Content Aware Fill. First, start off with the lasso tool here and make a lasso around whatever it is that you want to get rid of. You don't have to be right up against it. It can be just a little ways away. And I'll just kind of go around this. Make sure you catch the hair out there just in case. And I have mine set with a feathering of 1 pixel just to soften the edge, but just a little bit. I also have this set at Add to Selection right there. So let's go over here and add to the selection on this side. There we are. Just work right around the figure. And there it is. And get that hair right in there. Okay, there's our selection. You have to have a selection in order for the tool to work. So make sure you make a selection. Go up to Edit. And come down to Content Aware Fill. It's right there, right below the fill and the stroke. And this brings up a whole new dialog box, as you can see in here. Now the green part, this is showing you what you're going to be removing. And this shows you a preview of how it's going to look when it's finished. You can see it's already done a great job. Now with the fill up here, you can adjust your size right here, your brush size. You also can adjust the brush size by using the left and right square brackets, size is normal for a brush size in Photoshop. You can add to or remove from the selection. Now this doesn't add to or remove from what's inside of your selected area here where you have your selection, but you can remove or add to outside of the selection using that tool right here. Now you can set this either to work with the selection, which is right over here where it says excluded area, or you can go to sampling area. So you can do either, you know, either side of that. Next on here is a lasso tool. This one, you know, regular lasso and the polygonal. So you can adjust your selection if you need to, kind of fine tune that if you need to. And of course the zoom tool and the standard hand tool, your usual tools there. I actually haven't had any need yet to come in here and change anything after my initial selection. Take a look at that. If it's fine, you're all set to go and just click on OK. You can then make a couple of adjustments up here that I have found seem to help. You have color adaptation, none, default, high, very high, default has always worked for me. Rotation adaptation, I put this at low or medium just to give it a little bit, and that seems to help a bit. Now notice right down here it's refiguring based upon this change up here in the settings. And this seems to help out just a little bit on the quality. And you can also choose to scale and mirror. These things will help to hide any adjustments. I'll click on the scale. This also seems to help a little bit. And again, it's figuring that out right down below there. Once that has been figured out, we'll then take a look at how you want to output this. I have mine outputting to a new layer, which I would recommend. So you can always go back and just remove that layer like I showed you at the very beginning of this video. So we can do a current layer. I recommend against that. New layer or duplicate layer. I do the new layer so you have kind of an option on that. So I'll click on new layer. That's the default anyway. If you're not happy with your settings, you can click on these buttons here to reset to their defaults. And that's actually all there is to it. Click on OK. And there you go. Let's just go ahead and we'll deselect that. And there it is. Absolutely perfect removal in there. So there's the original and there's the cleaned up copy. Now, if I wasn't doing all this talking in here, this thing would take you just seconds. I mean, it's amazing how fast this thing actually goes to do this kind of a cleanup. So it's a beautiful new version here of the Content Aware Fill using the artificial intelligence from Adobe, and does a masterful job. And notice the clouds up here. The clouds are absolutely perfect. So phenomenal. One of the best things Adobe has done in a long time is this new Content Aware Fill here in Photoshop 2019. Don't forget to hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, and of course share and subscribe, and think about supporting my channel through Patreon. There's a link for that on my channel and also in the description. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop, and again there's a link for that in the description as well.